What's up, Warriors? We're here for our special patriotic video. Unfortunately, we had technical difficulties, so you're getting it a week late. And as you'll see from some of the other footage, basically I'm wearing a different shirt. We had to re-record this part of it, but we have some parts of it that did work. We just had audio problems, so here it is. Captain America disc launching shield. So, let's go with the orientation first. It's a hard plastic shield. It's got the disc launching section in the front here, your handle for the handle hold, Velcro strap to attach to your arm, and the trigger for the blaster. Four AA batteries go right here. We had a hard time figuring out how to review this because it's three things, kind of. It's a Captain America collectible for the movie, it's a blaster, and it's a shield. We're giving it blaster categories because this is still click-click rank. We've got a LARP slash melee weapon type of review coming up in the very near future here. It's going to be kind of a splinter, just the way our Super Soaker reviews are going to be. But since we're still in click-click rank, we're giving it blaster categories, although we're considering it a shield. That can be a blaster because it kind of needs the help. Let's get to the famous five categories. Start with speed. As speed goes, this thing's not too bad. On the front of the shield here, you've got two little levers. You pull those down, that pops open your top. That's your loading mechanism. Comes with five discs. Pop those in all at once, click it down, you're ready to go. It's not so bad. You can get about a disc per second on this, and that's not so bad. You know, if you're considering a pistol, you're about the same. The downside is, since it's an electronic blaster, it's got two wheels, but only one of them are powered. When you open the top, there's a little mechanism right here. This pushes that down so that it spins. And when you've opened up the front door, it cuts out power. So that's two safety issues that it probably didn't need. I'm glad you guys are thinking safe, but it's not necessary to have that much power off, especially since with only one flywheel, it takes a while for it to charge back up. That's why it was 1 second per disc. It could have been faster, but waiting for that power wheel to charge back up, you fire it too rapidly, like it shows in the front of the packaging, you're gonna see it shoot out the end and just fall straight down. Next up, let's go to range. This doesn't do too bad. The packaging says 20 feet. We were really expecting it to suck based off that. But as it turns out, with a nice straight shot, if you don't have really any high winds, this thing got about the same range as the barrel break and the sharp shot. You know, not too bad, especially if you consider those, we call them pistol category, and this is supposed to be a disc shooter. It's okay. You know, not top markings. We're not gonna give it a big boost to its score because it says 20 feet and it goes longer than that. The downside is, as you can see here, when you shoot it up in an angle, it's kind of like throwing a frisbee into the wind at the beach. Too high of an angle, it's going to come straight back down. And that's one of the downfalls of a disc ammo. Something I'm sure a lot of people are starting to be really curious about on how the Vortex line is going to do. But I think that's going to do fairly well. They're much smaller discs, so there's less area for the wind to affect it. They got some more density to them, so they're not going to just be wobbled all over by a wind. But we'll have to wait till September to really find out on that. Next up, we've got accuracy. The accuracy on this leaves a lot to be desired. Once again, I'm sure that's probably going to be a big concern with the Vortex line coming up, but we'll see. We'll see. Now this, we did our standard testing. We set up our 6 foot table and put some of the quick blast target cards at the end. I really expected this to do better, especially when you consider I'm pointing at my target. I should have gotten a better score than that. And we were inside, so it's not like there was a big cross breeze to knock off the accuracy. That being said, this I think is our lowest accuracy blaster we've done a review on. So keep that in mind. If you are using it as a shield, and its blaster capability as a backup for take a quick step back, plug one at your opponent, they're going to be close enough, you're probably going to hit. There's not going to be that big of a concern. But when it comes to accuracy, if you look at SG Nerf's rules for Nerf Wars, shields typically aren't allowed. So you would have to talk to the organizer, see if you can get it in under the qualification that it's a blaster. They may or may not let you use it as a shield. If that's the case, you're probably better off going with regular blaster, even if it streamlines. If you're using it for a melee shield, the impact resistance on this is fairly good. You're not going to be able to use it in a lot of LARPs because the fact that it's not covered in foam. And a lot of the LARPs that you would bring a shield to are usually fantasy LARPs. The blaster may not be useful for you. It's really got a down point in both of its categories on that. Next up, let's go with appearance. As a Captain America shield, it's not bad. It looks like a Captain America shield. You can't really mistake it for something else. We've seen some people complain because of the raised area here for the disc shooter that it's not perfectly like a Captain America shield. Well, if that's your argument, it's also not the right size. You can go for about $10 more onto Amazon.com, get yourself a 24-inch replica shield. I mean, if you're getting it for a replica, why are you spending $20 on a plastic toy that also works as a blaster? Captain America's shield doesn't blast discs out of it. So if that's your big argument against its appearance, I consider it an invalid. Let us know what you think. Should that be flat for it being a Captain America shield? We want to know your opinion. Other people have also said because of the silver, Captain America shield is red, white, and blue. Yeah, but does it really detract from it that much being in silver, especially if you consider they're trying to make it look like it's from the movie? It's a metal shield. We know it's a metal shield in the movie, and they put the red and blue on it. It's close enough that I'm not really dinging it on the appearance too much. It was something that if it was teamed up with something else, we may have given it a lower mark. But as it is, its functionality is really what lowers it in this score category. It looks like a Captain America shield. Great. Maybe a little smaller for a full-size person like me, but then it's probably the right size for a younger kid. The downside in its functionality is the trigger seems like it was made for someone with the right hand. But if you have a bigger hand like mine, your knuckles raise up when you squeeze that trigger. It doesn't cause a comfort issue. It just feels a little unnatural. You use it with the left hand. You can still squeeze it with these fingers. It doesn't cause the knuckle raise issue nearly as much. But then when you're holding it, you got an upside down star. It's not Captain America. Its functionality is a shield. Great impact resistance. Chris and I both kind of whacked at each other with one of the glow swords that you can see on our blog, clickclickbamf.com. You couldn't feel it really. I mean, you knew there was an impact, but it wasn't enough that you felt the power going through the sword to the shield to your arm. It's a great shield in that aspect, but once again, you're using it for LARP, you're going to have to mod it by putting a foam cover over it and or foam around the edge. You get a little too ambitious with a hammer block because it is so small. It's more like a buckler than a kite shield or anything along those lines. It could damage less resilient cores on weapons. Just something to keep in mind. Last category, we're down to value. This one was a tough one for us. If you were to take it in consideration as a collectible, it's okay. It's not bad. There are collectibles that are more expensive, collectibles that are less expensive. Taking it into consideration as a blaster, it scores pretty low. If you consider it as a shield, something you might want to try for LARP or roleplay at home, it's even worse. I think this is actually the lowest score this particular item is going to get. And with the scores the other categories got, being the lowest is actually kind of crappy, if you ask me. It retails for $19.99, which, thank you Toys R Us for actually selling it for its retail value instead of marking it up $3 to $5 or even more. It probably would have even scored even lower, except we were able to take into consideration that even though it doesn't do any of the things it's there for well, it's three things. It's a collectible, it's a blaster, it's a shield. So if you look at it and say, oh, I wouldn't have given it that high a score, it almost got lower.
If you look and say, oh, that's a low score, that's because it's shoddy for what it costs. Same cost if you're going for Nerf Wars, you can get a recon, a deploy. There's any number of $20 blasters you can get that do better. Especially if you go by SG Nerf rules and you're not allowed to have shields. This is all for look or bragging rights. And for bragging rights, you want it to do something more than just have a star and a couple stripes. I can't say I would recommend go out and buy this. If you got 20 bucks to spend, you want something cool, Captain America, go ahead and get it. If you're looking for something to use in LARP, I'm sure there's a couple of simple mods you could do so that it's usable in a LARP, but if you're going to spend money, you could probably, for the same cost or less, make a much more effective shield that there's going to be no question if you can use it. Especially if you're doing fantasy LARP, probably not going to be able to use the disc shooter anyways. So, take it as you will, make your own decision, and we want to hear your comments, your questions, your concerns. We're going to get to you as soon as we get a chance to. We do get back to you as soon as we can. If there's enough questions, comments, and concerns, we may do a follow-up video a week later called Shoot Back, where we address those. We answer any questions. If there's something we forgot when we're doing this thing, we address it there. So, you know, we want you to get more active with us because it gives us more opportunity to get active with you.
So there you go. Possibly one of our lowest reviews, and I think it was about time that we had something that didn't score insanely high. It didn't score bad, it just was average. And when you're looking for something to pick up, especially if you're going to reviews to figure out if you should pick it up, you want something that's better than average. So I can't say don't buy this, but I can't really tell you to run out and buy it either. That being said, maybe the demand for this will rise once we see the Captain America the First Avenger movie coming out. I'd like to see that. Till then, happy gaming. We'll be right back.